Hey guys, welcome to one more program. This is the Arm Balance program. Before anything, I'm gonna start to talk. You can pause me right now to warm up your wrists and your shoulders and your forearms, and just rotate them. Do this with your fingers. Rotate your shoulders back, because what I wanna get in the very beginning of this practice, it's already intense salutations, which we're gonna focus a lot on all the transitions of the sun salutation. So let's get started. By the way, we're gonna need blocks for this practice as well. Legs open, hips distance apart. Come to your Tadasana. And allow yourself to be present. Sending all of those signs to your body, waking your body up. Inhale. Inhale, hands and arms up. Exhale, forward fold. As I told you, we're gonna work a lot on the transitions. So from here, I want you to jump, walk, or float to your chaturanga. But start by challenging yourself. If you already walk, jump. If you already jump, float. If you're floating, go to your handstand. Of course, this is the very beginning. Try to work it up through the three videos that are going to come, okay? Bend your knees, come to the tip of your toes, jump back to your chaturanga. Inhale, bhujangasana. Exhale, downward dog. And we're gonna be here in downward dog for a second. BKS Iyengar says that if you're able to hold your downward facing dog for 5 inhales and 5 exhales, you are able to do a handstand. One more breath. Inhale, look between your hands. Exhale, bend your knees, jump, walk, or float between your hands. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fall. Inhale, hands and arms all the way up. Exhale, hands down to your heart. Two more times. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fall. Bend your knees, jump, walk, or float back to your chaturanga. Inhale, look between your hands. Exhale, tip of your toes, bend your knees, jump, walk, or float to the front of your mat. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fall. Inhale, halfway again. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, hands and arms up to the sky, Udvahastasana. Exhale, hands to your heart. One last time, watching out for your transitions. Inhale. Exhale. Bend your knees, come to the tip of your toes, knees towards your chest. That helps you to find that center line on your body, especially when you're warming up, where you still haven't taken your whole arm balance, your whole handstand, for example.
it's a nice way to start off to understand where's the right place for you to balance your body in the middle. So bend your knees, bring your chest toward your knees, and jump back. Deep inhale. Look between your hands. Come to the tip of your toes. Bend your knees. Now, I want you to bring the right foot to the left wrist and the left foot to the right wrist and sit down. We are going to need blocks. Grab both of your blocks. If you don't have blocks, it's not a problem at all. You can get books, boxes, anything that level up to each other. I know there's a huge shadow, but I kind of like it. It's kind of dramatic. I want you to extend your legs in front of you. Bring your blocks closer to your thighs. And we're sitting on top of our sitting bones. We've been there. I want you to spiral your sitting bones up, out. And wherever you landed your blocks, I keep saying that on my classes, I want you to bring them forward just a tiny bit, because the whole idea of the balance is to have an enormous amount of awareness on your shoulders. And we need to go forward to create actually an even more lower abdomen strength as well, because that forces this whole belt here in our bodies to get stronger in order to bring us up and to be holding ourselves forward. So let's do something. Inhale, bring the right leg up. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, bring the left. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, bring the right. Exhale, lower down. One more time. Inhale, bring the left. Exhale, lower down. One last time. Now what we're going to do, we're leaving our heels on the floor and only lifting our hips from the floor, okay? Bring your hands to your blocks, inhale, exhale. You can bend your knees a little bit, bring your feet to the floor if that helps you, okay? One more time, inhale. Lower down. Inhale. One more time. Take a deep breath. Lower down. I want to point something up, which is really important in the process of arm balancing. Inhales and exhales. Notice what is the process that aligns with your body the most. To go to an arm balance, do you need to inhale or exhale? Try this out. Try to inhale and bring it up. Exhale, lower down. And then try to inhale. Exhale. Notice the difference. Probably on your body, you will feel more intention when you exhale and search for your balance, which is a beautiful big symbol to, you know, just whenever we're feeling angry and all those heavy, dense feelings inside of us. We're normally just holding our breaths in. And in order to find the balance, what do you have to do? You have to exhale and let it out. So You know, it applies here, it applies in your life, it applies in so many things. So let's do this again. Take a deep breath. Lower down. Inhale. And then lower down. Shake your legs. Shake your shoulders. I told you we're going to use them. Your wrists. There's also a window for your wrists, for your joints to get used to that pressure and that utilization of it all the time. That meaning that your wrist might hurt, but it takes a while for you to get past off that place. Just keep working on it. But eventually it will stop hurting most of the times. It happened to me, it happens to a lot of yogis and gymnasts that I know. But also, of course, at all times, stretch before, warm up before the most you can. Right? Now I want you to cross your legs in front of you. And we're gonna do pretty much the same thing with your knees and your chest almost glued to each other. Inhale. Lower down. Inhale. Lower down. Inhale. Let's hold here for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Lower down with control. Beautiful. Extend your legs again. Inhale, bring the right leg up. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, bring the left. Exhale, lower down. Inhale to stay. Exhale, come all the way up. Inhale, bring the right. Exhale, bring the left. You can be in any place of this process, and you can keep working in any place of this process. But we're gonna go straight to it. There's an ad to it on the second video that I think you guys are gonna like it. I hope you do, but let's do this. Very slowly, taking your time. I'm gonna even do this a little, yeah. Right, so inhale. All right, this is better. Let's do this. Inhale. One last time. Let's do it. Inhale. Beautiful. Do this as many times as you want. If you want to do this whole sequence 3 times, just redo them in blocks. 3 times. That's perfect. Now we get rid of our blocks. And we're going to go for a transition. Crossing the legs in front of you, bringing your hands down to the floor, and your fingers are pointing forward, guys. This whole thing of bringing knees to chest, we're going to evolve that conversation throughout the videos. But again, it's where you find your center. Right? Because your center of gravity is here. If you bring your body all close together to it, it's easier for you to balance yourself. So bring your hands, your fingers forward, your knees towards your chest. And again, you can be on the loop of any of the forms of this transition. I'll tell you how to do it. You give me any feedbacks, any questions that you might have from it. But this is how we do. the way you get there, let me know. I'm more than happy to help. So you bring the knee towards your chest, you take your hips off the floor, and swing all the way back to your chaturanga. And then we meet all in downward facing dog. Inhale, bring the right leg up. Exhale, step between your hands. Now bring in one shot, in one balance, the left knee towards your chest. Deep breath. Inhale to stay. Exhale. One more balance. It's not an arm balance, but all balances are balances. Bring the navel towards your spine. One more inhale. Exhale, hands down. I want you to step down. Bring your hands now to the center. Your knees towards your triceps. And your, remember the shoulders. Shoulders go forward so you can keep that attention. Shoulders forward, your fingers pointing forward as well, and you can stay right here. Knees on top of your triceps. If you're feeling like a balance is coming, maybe taking one foot off the floor. Maybe the other one. Maybe both of them together. And then you tuck, bring the toes together, and breathe. One more time. Exhale, come all the way back. Extend your legs and forward fold. In the same exhale. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, forward. Plant your hands down on the floor. Maybe walk your hands forward. I'm a little back in the middle of my mat. Go all the way in front of your mat. Bend your knees, tip of your toes. Jump, walk, or float. Inhale. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, bring the left leg up. Exhale, step the leg between your hands. Beautiful. Take a deep breath here. In one shot, I want you to bring the right knee towards your chest. One more deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. Virabhadrasana 3. Deep inhale. Exhale from here. Utkatasana chair pose. Legs parallel to each other. Exhale, forward fold. Now point your toes 45 degree angle out. Try to bring your heels together. Bend your knees, hands in front of you. Now bring, and come back a little bit. Now bring your knees on top of your triceps and once again, go for your balance. Navel going towards your spine. Your drishti, your point of focus right down on the floor. And then come back. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bend your knees. Go all the way down. Come to your Navasana. Deep breath. Exhale. Inhale to stay. Exhale, cross your legs, bring your hands down to the floor. Inhale, just go a little bit backwards and then exhale, forward. One last time. Beautiful, lower down with control, cross your legs. deep breath. Connecting your thumbs with your index fingers, your Dhyan Mudra, your mudra for balance. We're chanting Om to close this first part of the practice. Namaste, yogis. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next video. Let me know what you think. Any questions that you have from any of the transitions. I just wanted to start right on the time, right on it, so we can get the most of these three videos. Thank you so much. See you soon.